Hey guys, welcome to Quad V. I am Menace, alongside me is Jinx, and we are bringing you guys the FastHosts Power Tournament's Grand Finals between Phantasmagoria and Western Wolves. It is currently the knife round. Chubby, man on his own as we play it here on Crossfire. Now, for anyone that has been under a rock, this is currently the biggest online tournament for COD 4 as of recent, and this should be a stellar one. Now, just to point out to you guys too, before we get to introducing the players and such, Western Wolves are coming in from the upper brackets, which means they only need one game win to take this one. Think of it as a best of three, but they got one map up. I know some people don't agree with the system. Trust me, I'm one of those people, but it is the system. We'll live by it. We'll be thankful for it because it's just, it's how it is. Either way, though, alongside me is Jinx. Jinx, how are you doing this evening?
I'm pretty good. It should be a pretty interesting match. I'm really excited for it, actually, because I think these teams, I would have picked them at the beginning, you know, to meet up at the end. They've been strong all along this tournament. Seen a couple games from them both. And I think it could go either way at this point. I think we're seeing two powerhouse teams, two of the strongest teams right now in COD 4. And it doesn't get any better than this, that's for sure.
Definitely so. Now, a quick little roster rundown before we get started here. For the Phantasmagoria side, we have got Vay, Skia, and Rio, Jermaine, and Zabza. And for the Western Wolf side, we've got rather star-studded Fantasy, Chubby, Meissen, Ono, and Froz. Which, I mean, what a stellar lineup, really. Either way, both of these teams definitely more experienced than anyone else that's come up in the tournament so far, and of course that's why they are in the finals. A quick little look back at the history we have seen. So let's have a look at this more in a statistical, statistical. This is how it ran pretty much. West Wolves got to the finals in the upper brackets by beating JTC 2-0, Golden Oldies 2-0, then they beat CGF 2-0, and then they actually beat Phantasmagoria 2-0. In the upper brackets. Of course, Phantasmagoria then dropped down, and with that I shall flick over to the lower brackets quickly to have a look. Now, because Phantasmagoria dropped down so late, they only had to play up against, I shall tell you now, they had to play up against Lowland Lions, in which they beat Lowland Lions 2-0, and of course now sit in the Grand Finals. They are the map down, but of course they can bring it back if they win this first one. Then it's all even Stevens, and then it is anyone's game for the finals. Now, first map, it says here on the system, is Backlot, but it seems that they're going to go for Crossfire. Not sure why, but it looks like they're going to be playing Crossfire. So, advantages, disadvantages of Crossfire? I mean, we got the attack side a little bit biased. How do you feel about Crossfire? Like, if you join a server in Crossfire, what's the first thing that goes on your mind?
Well, I think definitely taking that attack side is a lot stronger, because if you can get that bomb in quickly and get a really good defense on that bomb, once you get it down, it's really hard to counter it. Granted, there are some teams, like, I think I saw Golden Oldies pull it off a lot, and LOL, you know, there's a lot of teams out there that are strong enough to pull it back once the bomb is down, but 9 times or 8 times out of 10, the attacking side is going to win most of the rounds on Crossfire. But a team like Western Wolves, I mean, I'm going to say they're unpredictable, but they play similar, they play the same way a lot. But I think for teams like this who know each other really well, I think the advantage definitely goes for the attacking side, because they know the way Western Wolves are going to try to counter once that bomb's down. But then again, Western Wolves might be able to stop the bomb plant. And if they do, it's going to be hard for Phantasmagoria to really pick up the rounds that they need to pick up on the stronger side. So again, like I said, it should go either way, but attacking side, definitely what I want to gun for early on.
Alrighty, now, as I try and figure out the binds. Okay, it seems I missed something in COD 4. Anyway, either way though. One of the things we have to mention here, as Chubby is going into A building, one of the things, I actually want to point out a couple of areas we're going to be looking out for. So this A building is one of the big ones. A building, you can pretty much stop B bomb plants, and you also help out a lot to stop the A plant too. If you can hold off that A building, you've got a lot of the map secured from there. Of course, walls are paper thin in COD 4, so you've got to be very careful about where they sit. And of course, those SMGs love to go roaming and just spraying through those walls. On the other hand, we've got names like Froz on the server, which I'm pretty sure most people will be synonymous with his play in the light building, which is towards the top of the street on the left-hand side, behind the counter. So we will more than likely be seeing him on attack over there. See if I can flick over through the players and spot anyone there. Okay, we did just see Skia in here. Okay, so this area, very big for Froz to play with. Scopes, on the other hand, Honor plays a very aggressive style from last I checked. He does like going over to the B side to make sure he gets the Apex. And Zabza, last I checked again, he likes to sit back towards spawn building and actually try and go for the pick onto Ono. Of course, it does change up. These guys will change up their styles. They don't want to be predictable. As soon as you're predictable in this game, well, it's game over. If you're on the same path and someone else just nades you, you're out for the round. And it is really, 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 really important not to die in this game. I cannot stress that.
Especially on a map like Crossfire, you know, if you lose your aggressive players early on, it can be really difficult for the players that are back in the map, like either the ones that are back here or back half, and the players that are up towards the spawn house in light. It's hard for them to get in, and you know, you gotta have to play picks at that point. So I think the SMG's really gotta stay alive for the first couple of seconds.
Either way though, it is now the first round here. Guys, don't be fooled by the top of your screen. It is actually 0-0. Gonna be watching Zabza here off the start, seeing if he can maybe catch something here going into the cafe area. No, it doesn't look like it's gonna happen. Honor's got a little wall bang, probably trying to pick up any players going in towards light. Zabs is still setting back. He's heard the shots of Ono, but nothing is going his way just yet. Ono's still waiting for Zabs to cross the road, so he knows that Zabs has moved into that spawn building. Oh, but he has spotted a glimpse, and he is now on the prowl. Oh, and there it goes. First shot going from Ono. Lands onto Zabza. He'll be more than happy with that one. Vay's already a last man standing. 1v5. First round. Taking out one. Fantasy's going to get the final kill, though. And that's going to be Western Wolves only losing one player and getting the first round. Now, that looked a little too easy.
Yeah, they definitely played really well on the defensive side. Every player on their team got a kill, so that would be a team ace. That's very well played indeed. So we'll see if Phantasmagoria tie it back 1-1. And hopefully just forget about that last round and try to imagine it never happened. We do have a very aggressive Western Wolves here. Chubby dropped really far, but maybe a bit too far now. Jermaine will pick up a frag onto him. Skier will drop Fantasy. And now just three players remaining for Western Wolves as they will not push any further. The two pushing players did fall. Frost is in a good position now. It doesn't look like they're going to get that bomb down anytime soon. The smoke does go out, though. And Vay will fall. I believe Vay did not have the bomb, I don't think. Big end, that is Enrio. We'll go for that bomb plant, possibly. Just got to be a fake, though. We'll fall back to be safe. Meissen will test the wall there, but he's not going to tag the player. That is Ono coming in there with that. Deagle looks to pick up another one, but he is smarter than that. He's got to fall back. Look for that no scope. He's not going to get it, though, but he will go up and try to counter him now. It's 50 seconds remaining. There's two players there. And Zabzer kills him with that Deagle. Now, only two players alive for Western Wolves. We do have Meissen and Froz. He's got his eye on that bomb site. The smoke does go up, though, but Froz knows where to shoot regardless. Bomb is being planted, and it is going to be real there from Enrio. On top of the bomb, his smoke runs out, but he will get the bomb down and fall back. 2-1-3 after plant. Western Wolves have got to get another pick to even it up, but they're going to lose Meissen now. It is Froz 1-on-3 now, and he is exposed, and he's been called out, and he does get taken down there by Enrio. Good counter there from Phantasmagoria to stop the momentum there from Western Wolves.
Definitely so. It did seem like one of those situations where first round went to Western Wolves, in a quick style, and I think that instantly triggered for Phantasmagoria to sit back, and I don't think Western Wolves' decision of being aggressive in the second round, trying to, you know, keep Phantasmagoria kind of back in spawn worked out, because Phantasmagoria wanted to turtle anyway. They knew that Western Wolves just played very aggressively, and, I mean, they're definitely going to sit in the second time round. So with that, we will be seeing Chibi going to be the first man to go down in this round, although it looks like the game pace has been relatively slow. We do see Ono going towards back A with that scope and SMG, so he's got a little bit of extra weaponry to work with. Of course, he did pick up Chibi's gun, and Skier sitting lower light. He just wants to make sure no one's utilizing that back A area. He has tagged up Froz, but he's going to go for the hide. He doesn't want to be picked off anytime soon, and Rhea with a nade onto Fantasy. Ooh, there we go, Phantasmagoria, quick style, clean off the loss to Western Wolves. And what for a very biased first round towards Western Wolves, a sketchy second round to now a completely biased third round. And I think Phantasmagoria have now woken up.
Oh yeah, exactly. Like we said, those early rushers cannot go down early. And we did see that though, as Fantasy, actually he went down quite late, but it was Chubby who went down quite early. Not good for them. Fantasy does go down early this round, though, and so does Ono. Skier maybe being a little too aggressive himself. We'll push a little too much. Frost is in a good position. We'll drop him. Chubby's still alive, though. Got to throw that nade. Not sure that's going to hit anybody. I wouldn't think so. It will not. So we have a 3v4. The bomb is going down. It's going to be a fake now from Vay. Trying to lure them out. Oh, didn't see that first bomb plant. Will be a fake, though. It is Vay onto Frost there through the wall there. So that was nice. Enrio will fall. And now there's only two alive for Western Wolves. The bomb is going down there from Vay. You will put it down and fall back. Jermaine was in a good position, but he falls back as well. So does Zabzer. And now Chubby's got to be on the offensive. Does have that MG. I believe he might have an SMG with him, though. The car does get tagged. Chubby, though, fell before the car could blow up. And now it is Meissen who also got tagged. They're right behind each other. Meissen somehow stayed alive through that. He's able to spot one. He spots a feed of, I believe that is Zabzer, and he sprays that, trying to pre-fire. He's not going to find them, though. Look around, Blum can't find him, he's right behind him, and Zadzu takes him down with the Deagle. 3-1 now for Phantasmagoria, that's very good for them.
Yeah, that one really didn't go towards towards West Wolves in the end. It does seem like, I don't know, it's kind of towards the middle game, it seems like they all want to sit in and be aggressive at the exact same time. So you kind of have like the stutter movement, where someone rushes forward and then just sits still. It's like, okay, they'll come to me, but a little bit slower this round. No one's died in the early seconds. We do see Chibi's nade going out. I think that one was more of a hope nade. I don't think that's actually going to connect with anything. Oh, it was just over the A building. I thought it was going to get a little bit further. Honor with a shot onto Zabza. Seems Honor is coming out on top of the scope battle. At this point in time, Meissen spraying in towards lower light. Going to have to fall back as loads of lead flies in his direction. Jermaine just sitting in that light. Seems to be taking up Froz's counter positioning. Skier pushes up onto Chibi. After 45 seconds, only two players are down. And I think if we can get the definition of slow player, this one is it right now. Fantasy peeks around at the perfect time, using the enemy smoke to his advantage and takes out Vaze. That bomb tries to go down. He's got to be careful. He knows Skier is towards that A building. And of course, Skier in top A. And this is where the positioning is so useful. Oh, he has spotted Meissen in Cafe. Tags the player up there. And of course, still trying to find Fantasy. I think he actually tagged Fantasy up with that Deagle. And Rhea moving into...
Ana's got one.
Oh, yeah, spotted it. He lets up a shot, tags up Jermaine. Oh, lands it through the wall. Fantastic stuff from him. And now with that, we only see a skill last man standing. 15 seconds left on the clock. There's no way he's going to be able to get to the bomb in time. Ana's going to pick him off. Wow, Ana with sitting all the way in the top of the ruins area. I don't think that's a position we see all that often, but it seems to work out very well for Ana. Sitting on 6 frags after only 5 rounds.
It did. At the moment, he just needed to stay in a spot where he could cover the middle of the street and stay alive. He was able to do so. They weren't able to pick him up. They weren't able to pick up Ana early on. But Ana will find Zabzu, so he's definitely winning that scope battle. Zabzu with 2 Deagle frags, so he's not been up to a whole lot. Fantasy will follow and reply, and now it's just a 4-on-4. Bomb looks like it is back, still invasive. They're not being too aggressive. Jermaine will find Chibi. Skier, though, will fall as well. And now it is a 3-on-3, so they're still very close at this point. They will check out a nade. That will not connect to anybody now. He might go for a bomb plant, or at least a fake. Yeah, we are going to see a fake. And he'll fall back because the nades are planting right there. Froz goes down on the bomb site. Meissen does fall there to Enrio. They will pick one up as well on Froz. And now it is just Ano, last man remaining. With that scope, he's got to go 1v3. Not something you see a whole lot. Well, there's bot one there on the bomb. Not going to find the frag, though. Or a tag, for that matter. With 50 seconds remaining. He's got his... Oh, he has his scope on his head. There, we'll find him now. Vay is down. So that plant will not go through. Not going to pick up that AK there right behind him. Interesting choice. Walk up with that Deagle, but there is Enrio coming up from the behind and taking him down. 4-2 now for Phantasmagoria.
I think it was a little weird that Ona actually reacted so slowly as Rhea jumping in on him, because he heard the SMG, but it's not like he got up and sprinted. And I honestly, I mean, that's like first instinct for me, and it just didn't seem that Ona was paying too much attention to that one at this point in time. Either way, we do see Enrio with a very fast run towards a B plant. Are we going to be getting this bomb down quick? Looks like it is. There's loads of noise to try and cover up the sound of the bomb going down. Vase pushed into Bialy. That means that Fantasy is going to be taken out. There's no one to stop the bomb. Meissen's nade coming in, but it's a little bit late. And now the tables have completely turned. There's still 8 players left. But the thing is, that is now up to Essen Wolves, and they need to get in there quickly. Only 2 more players left, as Fan still stands strong. Skier takes out Ono. He's demolishing this A site. He's calling it his own and marking his territory. And now we have Jermaine up against Froz. Froz, your last man standing. He's taken up by Vay. And that'll be 5-2. 3 rounds in the lead now. Phantasmagoria looking strong, which in all honesty is good, because that means we get to see a third/second map.
Yeah, they are definitely looking really good indeed. Well, they do have the stronger side, but look at a guy like Ana playing very well indeed with 8 frags. The next person behind him will be Chibi with 3. So Ana's definitely doing a lot of work, but it is crossfire, so you can imagine that. Chibi will fall early again. It's not going to be good for Western Wolves. That is Skier, again, like you said, is just pushing into that A site. Though he's not going to find another frag. Gets taken down there from Froz. All eyes now. It will not be another early plant from Phantasmagoria. But they've got their eyes on that B-bomb site in case they try to pull anything off. It's a 4v4. Vay, I think, still has his nade. He was looking to throw it, but I think he was going to. Froz, around for one at light. He's not going to find it. So, not sure if there's any player there, but look at Phantasmagoria. They've got 3 players relatively close to each other. If an aid was to land there, it would not be good. But they're going to spread out now. There's Fantasy pushing up. He could surely go massive if he gets in there. He's got one. Pulling out the Deagle. He's got to drop Zod through his funnel. The bomb will go down, though. That is Vay. And the pace will slow now. Now there's 2 players remaining. It is Vay King and Jermaine with a 4-on-2 after plan. Jermaine might go down. He's heavily tagged. Vay's not in a great position as well. Jermaine hopping into the middle of the street. Vay will find Fantasy. But Vay will follow and reply there from Meissen, who does get taken down as he went for a plant, or a defuse rather. But he was not able to. There is Jermaine, able to tag up another, but not going to find that frag in there as Ahno with a great position there at the top of the street. Well played there from Western Wolves. Ahno able to win that battle. It's good for them. So 5-2, or 5-3 now. It is the defensive side picking up a much needed round.
Two moments in that round that just got me. Vay, how the hell did he stay alive? Being sprayed and naded and everything.
I have no idea. Jermaine, too. He was
and
heavily
tagged Jermaine's as well. Peak onto mid street. I mean, his first two rounds hit. And then he just like peaks back in. But unfortunately for him, didn't expect Honor to be pushing up that quickly. And it was taken up. Either way, they're well played from Fan, even though they did lose the round in the end. It is definitely one of those valiant effort ones. And they can put a half tick on the round. And we do see Askia once again playing that lower light oh so well. He has got one towards the top of the stairs. Flash comes out to try and distract him. He's going to fall back, make sure that no one pushes up on his teammates. And of course, that just simply lays down a basis for them to start picking off Froz moving out into B alley. They know they've cleared it. And it's actually an interesting position to have an AK in there. They've got an SMG there too. So Fantasy in there with a cover. They've got to be careful. They know loads of nades have been landing yet in the B alley. So they don't want to peek it too much. Jermaine goes down. Superb shot there from Froz. And this means a 3-4. And looks to be standing strong for the defending side. Coming back after being three rounds down. Only two, and this one, I think, might just go in their favor too. Fantasy staring up the ceiling, making sure that no one jumps in on his teammates. We see Skia peeking from the exact same spot Jermaine did. And if his team learned anything, that's definitely not a good idea to peek the exact same spot your teammate died. And we do see Vay taking up Fantasy. Trying to even it out once again. Vay goes over the wall, but Ono's shot rings in. Skia's your last man standing. And I don't think he's going to have this one. He's in a bad position. He's been tagged up. He's going to be taken up from the side probably any second now. Tries to move forward. Ono once again. SMG. Ono's playing so aggressively. It's paying off. I'll give him that much. You know, 12 frags, 9 rounds. Probably casual for him. But it's very aggressive, especially in the finals.
He's having a great game right now. Going 12 for 5 early on. And not all of them have been scope frags, so... He's playing his pride as a great player. He will drop Viking, so that is a big frag. As Vay is usually one of the last ones alive every round, so that is big for him to drop him early. He's not able to find Zabzer, the enemy scope. Let's see where he is. Zabzer, nade in hand, just, I think, timing it at this point. Waiting for his teammate, who I believe would probably be Enrio with the bomb. Yes, it is. It is. And Enrio is making his way towards the bomb site. Fantasy will fall there from a nade from Jermaine. The smoke will go from Enrio. We'll see if he goes. A plant. I think they're just waiting for the all clear. The 4v3. So Western Wolves would like to get another frag to make the job of planting that bomb a little bit more difficult. Ono just got to time up a nade, but it's not going to happen. The opposite will happen, actually. Froz will fall. Now it is a 4v2. If that bomb does go down, it's going to be very difficult for Western Wolves to pull it back. See now. Bomb. Still in the hands of Enrio. He's not going for anything yet. They're going to try and get a few more picks. That is Zabzer there into Meissen, and there will be Skier. Come up Ono, so they don't even need the bomb plant. They can just push in and take them down. So it's not good for Western Wolves, but 6-4.
Well, definitely not. Seems that they were just drawn up by those bomb plants. As you can see, Enrio using it, you know, so well to his advantage, just in the sense of make a fake, run away from the bomb. It's going to draw it either gunfire or a grenade. And, you know, from one of those two, you can kind of pinpoint a play. We do see Fantasy being very aggressive. Takes out one, goes for a second. Both SMG franks. That's Skier and Vay down. That is two very big defending players for them. Bomb has gone down, but I think that was probably not the best idea. Zapsa goes down too. Fantasy's gotten three of the five players already. He's going for the fourth. The player's off to his right-hand side. Oh, he won't be able to pick up the frag. Honor takes out Jermaine with the deagle. Bomb's already defused. Wow, that was a quick round.
Wow.
Fast plant, fast defuse, and fast round right into the hands of Western Wolves.
All five Western Wolves players stayed alive that round, so that was good for them. Fantasy did not do what he usually does. You often see him go B on B alley, but he did go A that round, and it worked. They had to pick up three frags with it, and almost grab a fourth. We'll see if what he's trying this round. Looks like he is going to go B again, back to his usual Fantasy stuff. See if Phantasmagoria is up to. Or just taking it slow again. Vay has that bomb. They're not being too aggressive. Now they're pushing in the checkered yet. Skier will fall, so that's a good early pick for Western Wolves. Phantasmagoria still moving so slow. They could use a pick right now. They could use a frag without one of the people that is watching that B-bomb set. It will be Fantasy that falls, so that is good. Nice nade there from Jermaine. I've taken out Fantasy, I think, a couple of times so far this map. Roz has got his eye on the bomb site, and it will work! As he will drop Faking with a beautiful headshot there through the wall. Or through the bomb, rather. And he has Panther 2 trying to find another. Jermaine is staying alive. Not anymore, though. Chibi was in a good position to take him out. Meissen will fall as well. But it is... Is that us that Tiger, or is that the server?
I think that's server.
Yeah, I quieted because I wasn't sure if that was me, but...
Alright, carry on. We'll carry on, though.
Alright, I guess we're carrying on, then. Otto and Frials will find the two last frags, and Phantasmagoria are not going to be happy with that round. Neither would Western Wolves, I would imagine.
Seems we will be having a couple of issues. No worries, guys. We'll try to get that sorted out as soon as possible, and I'll keep you guys updated on that one. Of course, with this one going, at the moment, we'll just have to try and keep it as live as possible. But unfortunately, these things do happen. If you guys are new, if you guys don't understand what's going on, pretty much what's happened is someone's found the IP address and they're kind of pretty much DDoSing the server. So we're having a couple of connection issues. We just have to unfortunately go with the flow, either find a new server.
Classic COD 4 online finals, I'll just say that right there.
I mean, I don't think it would be a finals if we didn't have this.
No, not at all.
I mean, I think it happened for, what was it, Lowland Lines versus a Nexus?
Yeah.
That one also happened.
Yeah.
I believe I had one where they actually did my connection directly. I don't know how they did that one, but they got it right. Impressive stuff. So, I think this is actually, you know what, this is a good moment. Guys, if you do want to follow us, if you do want to check us out, the commentators, I am Menace. You guys can check me out on Twitter, at Menace. And then, of course, we have Jinx. You guys can see him on YouTube, and that is J-I-I-N with five X's. Because he's
too complicated, I apologize.
He's too cool for Twitter, guys.
I'm too old school for this
Facebook.
Social media.
He's got the YouTube right up in there. So go check him out. Like it, subscribe. Subscribe, wow.
Yeah.
Alright, but either way, I think we're just going to check, make sure that the server is fine. Looks like these players already readied up, so looks like they're good to go. They're feeling confident. And they will...
That last round going to count? It might, because I think it wasn't fully lagged out, it was just a few seconds.
It was a semi-lag out. I don't know how much it affected the players. Chibi calling a timeout, it's one of those moments you could start arguing, saying, yeah, but you know, he was in the process of checking server details and server connections and things like that. So every player will probably have some other connection problems that they'll want to, not whine about, but they'll want to mention. I think either of these teams are sportsmen enough to either say, listen, we understand you guys had the round, or if you guys don't feel that, we'll replay the round. I think we'd hope that
it would be that way, but it doesn't always go that way. But with these teams, you know, at the highest competitive level for COD 4, it probably will be pretty fair, I would imagine.
Now, we're just waiting for a couple more players to ready up, and then we'll be back underway. I think at the moment they're just doing a little X-Fi scan to make sure, see who's on X-Fi and who's not. Of course, if you guys are wondering why we say that, it's because the IP address for COD 4 can be seen if the person is connected to the server and on X-Fire. Luckily for me, though, disable that. Purely because I don't want to actually log how many hours I play on COD 4. I think that's the more embarrassing thing.
Yeah.
Alright, so here we go, guys. All back and ready to go. Looks like they're all ready. They're all happy. Some people are saying the other time that during the halftime. It's one of those things, guys, that happens. Either way, though, we are now back into the game. So let us take it away now. It is, of course, the second half of the first map of the grand finals of the FastHosts Power Tournament. It is a 6-6 scoreline. Phantasmagoria now defending after they had the chance to choose their sides. Now, we'll mention at this point that that's not ideal for Phantasmagoria. They wanted at least a one-round difference going on to the defending side. You need to have the advantage coming off attack. Attack is not easy to hold off, and especially knowing that Western Wolves only need one map to win this. They are upper map because they come from the upper brackets. So it is going to be an unfortunate situation if Phantasmagoria don't bring this one back. They need to try and hold on. Lucisky are peeking out from top A. He's been playing it so well. Unfortunately, sprang through the window, just giving away his position. Frozzle shut him down. And it looks like Jermaine's already lined up his nades. Looks like he's going to try and catch up the players as they move in. He might not. Ooh, just too early. And now we'll have to go for the Wolbang. Lines it up, and it looks like he's hearing some tags. It's not deterring the bomb planter, though. Nade comes in. Meissen goes down. Meissen not having the best game so far. That has to be said. And Zabs will be the one to take down Ono. Looks like with the sides changing, we might have a scope dominance changing too, as Ono was pretty much on top of all the scope shots. And Froz has been outplayed here. He hasn't actually noticed the player moving up here on his right-hand side and should be... No! Vayne, what are you doing? They're literally playing Ring Around the Rosie right now, Ring Around the Lighthouse. It looks like Vayne is going to cross over towards that bomb side, try and stop the bomb planter. He's calling that it's a fake, which is, I mean, as good as stopping the bomb plant. And now we'll be able to move onto the bomb side. Has spotted the final player that is going to be Froz moving down the street. And first round going towards Phantasmagoria on defense. Now, the same happened when we had sides the opposite way around. The people on attack did lose the first round, so maybe it's just them trying to get into their groove. And we'll see a little bit of a different Phantasmagoria in a bit.
Yeah, it may just take a little while to get adjusted here to the attacking side. Ono will find one, though, on Tenryo, so that's good for them. Chibi will chime in on Vaking, so that's very good now. Two players down early on. Skier, though, around that A side again. Did great work on it on the last side. We'll see if he can continue that. He's playing a pretty good game himself, going 12 for 10 right now, but he's doing all for his team. And Fantasy will drop Jermaine. Looks like the bomb plant is going to go out with a 2v4 afterplant. Make that a 1v5 afterplant, actually, because Zazra will fall there to Fantasy, and Chibi will pick up Skier. So that is very well played there for Western Wolves to tie it back up. So the pattern will keep on going.
More or less. Now, the thing is that Western Wolves just need to try and keep up this dominance. They've had their first run where they kind of tinker around with each other, see who's playing what and who's playing how and where. And now it's just a case of being able to close up those positions. I think on the defending side, you're a little bit more limited, especially with the likes of pretty much every Western Wolves player right now. And the state of their geek nades is just incredible. Literally, you can sit anywhere on the map and they will be able to nade you. So, it's one of those things Phantasmagoria kind of want to keep on moving around the whole time, but of course they also want to make sure that they've got all their positions on lock. Frost spraying through the wall, just tapping away on those spots that he knows oh so well, and just trying to make sure that no one pushes up onto the light area. Bomb goes down. There's still four players left for Western Wolves. Four players left for Phantasmagoria, and all five still up for Western Wolves. So this is a situation where it's kind of like all teams are still standing, but the bomb has somehow gone down. Not much contention on either. We do see Chibi taking out Vay. Fant is going to keep around the corner. There is someone there for him. He will take out Jermaine. Goes for a second onto Zabza. Makes it look so easy. How does he do it? I want to play like that.
Well, it seems like Western Wolves are starting to find their groove. I mean, Phantasmagoria plays defense very different than Western Wolves, so maybe more or less difficult for them to figure out their strategy, but it seems like Western Wolves are finding their spot. So if that the pattern will continue, and that would probably mean Fan would pick up this round, but no frags early on. Nades from Western Wolves not doing too much work early on. Phantasmagoria may be able to hopefully can figure out for their sake where these nades are going and try to stay clear of them. The bomb is being planted, I think it was. It must have been a fake there from Chibi, as he will fall back. So five alive for both teams. Chibi's gotta go in for this plant now. Oh, it is another fake. Trying to draw out more nades, but I think they've just about got them all. Hazard's nade was the one that worked first round. I wonder if he's thrown out a nade. Nobody does have a scope. Scope down on that side, but Ono will pick him up through the wall. Nice shot from him. Jermaine will drop Chibi. Froz will drop Viking, though. So now only three players versus four. So it's not a bad afterplant scenario here for Phantasmagoria. There is still some potential. But it is starting to fade away. As Fantasy will drop Jermaine, though. Nice from Skier, able to take down Froz now. He's looking for another. He's going to find it on the Meissen. And now it's just a 2-on-2, so they've done a good job to try and pull this back. There's Skier looking for a third. Spamming through the bust, not able to drop Ono. This heavily tagged will fall back to a much safer position. See if he goes for a peek now, he will. Not going to find anything. Peeking out with that Deagle, which is very strong for him. With 9 seconds remaining, doesn't look like they're going to get this defuse. They will not, because Fantasy is right there, and he will drop Skier. Ono did fall, though, from Skier before he passed. 9-7 now for Western Wolves, who are definitely looking really strong on the attacking side. That's how it's played.
No, really so. And one of the things I've noticed a lot of is that we do see the SMGs for Western Wolves really isolating up the BLE well. It looks like the teams are trying to focus on each other's, I want to say, weak positions. We see that Western Wolves not so much playing this A side, although on this run, things have completely changed. Let me shut up for a moment. But what Western Wolves were doing is they would just clean out their BLE completely. I mean, they had Fantasy and Vay in there the last... Vay? What am I saying? Wrong team. Chibi. Were in the BLE last round together. And... It's just like they're able to clean down so well, so you have to kind of pick off from A, but A, with Ono alive, makes it just more difficult to try and defend that bomb site. And now it just seems that they're swapping things around completely. They say, well, balls to the wall, guys, let's switch it up and confuse the daylight out of Phantasmagoria. So much so that the last two players are all the way back at the spawn, the top of a hill, and we do see that Jermaine is also pretty much similar. They don't feel safe with any of their positions. They'd rather just stick all the way back to spawn and hope for the best. We do see Jermaine moving up. He's just once again going to make sure that all that top A area is clear. Of course, Western Wolves were all over that site, so he's going to feel very nervous trying to move forward. He wants to try and defend the bomb. The problem is, as soon as he moves out there, the player from A will try and pick him off. So it's kind of the catch 22. Got to risk it, but on the same note.
Oh, nice shot.
They don't want to give away too much. We do see Zabs with their pickoff, and as you guys hear Jinx there mention it, I say mention it, just kind of notify me of it. And the bomb going down today, and the problem is, if Zabs connects this nade, ooh, that is so close.
Nope.
If they're able to... Oh, it's only Zabs now. Frog just peeking out to take out Jermaine. Zabs lands a shot onto Myson. It's a one-on-one, and he's got a very good hunch about where the last player is. Unfortunately for him, he doesn't have the correct weaponry for it. And this will mean that Frog does clear up the round. 10-7, three rounds in the lead, only three more left for Western Wolves to take this grand finals.
Yeah, just showing that Zabzer definitely has some power in that skill, but if he will drop Enrio, maybe Zabzer can shake things up. That would be... actually, that is Ono taking that Enrio. What am I saying? But hopefully Zabzer will show us more of that action. It'll be sweet to see. And definitely for fans' sake, they require it at this point. Western Wolves up 10-7, so they got a three-round advantage, so they got a bit of a cushion, but I don't think you can expect Western Wolves to lie down and take it. Chubby and Ono. We'll take two frags. Chibi will find Viking as well, and now it is just Zabzer last remaining, and he is so tagged at the moment. He'll be dropped there from Ono, so... Oh my god, Western Wolves exploding there through the map, and able to drop Phantasmagoria like a tsunami.
That's one of those things. Just once again, we saw that Chibi was able to push all the way into Cafe. I mean, he literally lay down behind the counter, waited for Jermaine to push in. So, it's just, they're clearing out that BL area too fast. I don't know how, but the Western Wolves player were able to drop a smoke right on top of the light post. And we do actually see Phantasmagoria being very aggressive over on the B side. Vay's already gotten two. Chibi pushes up to take out Skiu, who actually made his way into the lights. And now, as much as Western Wolves look behind, they're actually in pretty good positioning right now. They've got a player over towards A. Myson takes out Vay. And now Chibi is on A2. Now, this just means that they'll be able to pick off more, especially the player in the cafe and the player in Bielli, which is two of the last three remaining four Phantasmagoria that might go down. So they got to be very careful about the next couple of moves. As much as the aggression was good for Phantasmagoria, it seems that it's just not working out for them this round. You see Chibi be moving in towards that back area. Looks like he's just on a peak run. He still wants to find the frag over towards either the Bielli or Cafe. Unfortunately for him, he's not going to get any of it. Chibi with the deagle there onto, and Rio lands it. Spots Jermaine, goes for the spray through the wall, won't be able to finish off that frag. They know where Zab's ready, he's still sitting.
Well, that nade's gonna work.
Nade onto Myson, and that is a big game changer. Now the last two players are over towards A, but the bomb's at B, so they got to cross that street. Zab's not really in the best positioning to defend it though. He's going to finally move up, and if he comes around this corner, he will see two very cowardly running Western Wolves players. Froz takes out Zabza. It's only Jermaine, last man standing. He's in the cafe. He's got some counter, but if he can't take out, he lands the shot into Chibi. There's 15 seconds. Froz now needs to run across or either get this frag. I don't think he's going to be able to do this. There's no way for him to get there in time. And he's dedicating way too much time to go up to Jermaine. Jermaine saving that round to bring back to 11-8. But still, the three-round lead stands. And I think that's the most scary thing of it all.
Yeah, but they need more plays like that. That was big from Jermaine. I really needed to land that. And that shot through the wall onto the bomb planter, and definitely Zabzer's nade, definitely round changers. They need more stuff like that if they want to drop a power-hungry team like Western Wolves. We've got Myson moving in with that bomb. He's got to go. I wonder if it's going to be a reel or not. He will back off. Vay did fall early on, so that makes the job a little bit harder for Phantasmagoria to stop this bomb plant. They're having none of it yet, though. Jermaine's in another good position, though. Zabzer will fall scope on scope there from Ono again. Leading the charge with that scope. And there's a nade there from Enrio onto Myson. I believe somewhere through the mix of that, Chibi fell as well. It's a 3-on-3. The bomb doesn't look like it could be planted anytime soon.
Interesting route we see Froz taking. He's actually gone all the way around to spawn.
Yeah. Ono's got a really good beat there on cap, but he's got to find Jermaine, who was there. Roz, oh yes, Roz indeed is all the way back. Oh, this could be big. If he can take out Jermaine, that's taking out one of their clutch players. Jermaine will follow the Toano. I knew he had a good beat on him, and he was able to take him down. Looks like they will go for that bomb play. No, might be a little bit safer. Now there's only Skier and Unreal, and they're both on the other side of the street. And with the scope still up, it's going to be very difficult to cross the street. Froz, again, in a great position there at the back. So keen from him to get all the way back there. It just was able to change this round. Looks like they will pick this up, though. Skier and a 1v3. Deagle in hand. And no, that will be Ono with the Deagle. Much more powerful. Drop him down. 12-8 now. It is a match point for Western Wolves.
Four match points on the board. I don't think Western Wolves could have asked for it any easier.
For all the marbles.
I mean, Phantasmagoria have put up a great fight so far, but it just doesn't seem to be just enough. Now, we do see Ono once again starting. Oh, wait a minute. Wait. Back up. Ono, what are you doing, man? Really? I speak of praise and you shoot your teammates in the back of the head? That's not cool. No. Western Wolves down early on, and not even thanks to the enemy. We do see Bay taking out Ono, though. So not only did Ono kill his teammate, but he also kind of died for nothing. Frost takes out two with Deagle in hand. Jermaine onto Chibi. This means that Phantasmagoria, the man up, but they have to get to the bombsite quickly. And Meissen sitting back at spawn, and I really feel like doing the whole toss, but can he do it? He needs the one under the bang bus to take out. Oh no, it's not going to happen. We do see Frost though tagged up heavily as he does take out Zabza. Meissen should be killed off any second. He has got Jermaine. Jermaine misses Meissen. No!
Oh no!
Meissen, our last man standing. Oh, he's going to peek, and he's going to be able to shoot Jermaine under the bang bus.
Oh, no!
No!
Plus 10, maybe.
Oh! And he wins it!
He's done it to save Phantasmagoria, to save Western Wolves.
And we'll be going into not overtime. But that's GG's, guys. That is it. That is done. I cannot believe that was so quickly. It was so...
Wow.
I nearly wanted to say it was PCW-like. It was just over. One map. All done. Cleaned up. Nothing more to worry about. Western Wolves will be taking home their share, their very fair share of the £5,000 of the FastHosts Power Tournament prize pot. Of course, a massive shout out to our sponsors for this one is FastHosts Game Show Battles. And of course, epic.lan. Guys, you need to go to epic.lan. Everyone needs to go to epic.lan. They've got a new venue. It's amazing. Everyone, Jinx, come on, fly down from Canada, man.
I'm betting it'd be a lot of fun. I'm definitely considering it. It's one of the best lands I think I've been able to see. epic.lan was a great success, as well as epic.gate. So definitely,
awesome,
guys.
And of course, internet. New internet.
Yeah, thank God. I think we all had our fun watching the stream last time, and the internet was not so great as we heard.
So. Yes, but anyway, so that is it, guys. That is us closing off for this tournament. Of course, if you guys do want to go check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. You can see us on facebook.com/quadv, at quadv on Twitter, and of course, for all our videos on demand, this current game, and of course, anyone's in the past, /quadvtv. If you want to check me out, I'm at Menace on Twitter. If you want to check out Jinx, he is /JIIN and 5Xs on YouTube. Because he's cool.
I'd like to
like
actually thank Menace for letting me do this. It was a lot of fun, guys, and thank you all for watching. Great game.
Brilliant stuff, guys. But anyway, I hope you have an awesome evening. But from myself and Quad V, this is us signing out. Good night.
Good night.
from myself and Quad V. This is us signing out. Good night.
Good night.